Hi there. This is the Wi-Fi 6SS point, which is the new technology. Not only it can provide fast speed, but also improve the performances in crowded environment. But how can we power the Wi-Fi 6SS point? Today in this video, I'm going to talk about two methods that can power it. But before we jump into the video, make sure you hit the like button. It will really help with the YouTube algorithm and make my life a whole lot easier. So let's get right into it. The first method is called the passive PoE, which I don't really recommend it. Well, and I will tell you why. First, we all know the Cat6 Ethernet cable has four twisted pairs. With the passive PoE method, we have to move two pairs for power and the half pairs for data. I'm just moving the random pairs. It might step down the speed down to 100 megabyte, and it also may cause us a safety problem. The voltage would dynamically change during the operation, so it may cause us over or low voltage. So this is a primitive solution. And you have to know what you're dealing with before you go for the passive method. The second method is called the standard PoE. Well, both methods has the name PoE in it. It sounds really similar, right? But actually it's totally different. The standard PoE has power handshaking, which means the PoE injector or the PoE switch will verify the edge device before it releases the power. If the injector or the switch cannot verify any edge devices, it will not send power over. It's pretty safe, right? And also, it supports all four pairs together to send power and data. That means the speed can go up to 10 gigabytes. And this is the standard PoE method. Now, let's move on to the demonstration board and I'll show you how to put up a Wi-Fi 6SS point network system. So here we are at the demonstration board. This is the router with an internet access. And we're going to install the Wi-Fi 6SS point at the edge. And we have the Cat6 cable right here between the main network and the SS point. Today, I pick a 90 volt PoE injector. It is actually depends on the power budget of your device. Since my Wi-Fi 6 requires 40 watts, that's why I need to use the latest PoE standard BT to supply. A PoE or PoE Plus will only provide about 25 watts, and that might not be enough. All right, now let's come closer and take a look. Let me power the injector first. And we have two ports right here. Make sure you plug in the data port to the main network to get internet access. Now we're going to use the Cat6 cable from the edge device. Plug into PoE port to combine both power and data and send it back to the edge device. Now we are all set. Let's come over here. Just simply plug in the cable line to your device. And let me put it back up. And when the indicated lights are all on, you're ready to go. The whole setup is pretty easy, right? And do you remember that I mentioned about the power handshaking between the injector and the edge device? It is only working because my Wi-Fi 6SS point is PoE compatible. If your device doesn't have a PoE feature built in, that means the injector cannot send the power over to the edge. In this case, you will need the PoE splitter. Watch my another video about how to work with a PoE splitter. Now, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.